Jamie, thank you for being here with us.
Nice
it has
be
been
here.
An awfully big month for Nordstrom. You opened the new flagship store, and you just reported your earnings as well for the entire company. And when we talk about the company as a whole, good performance, especially in the face of rival department stores. But the department store segment alone, sales were still down 4%. Is this a format that just is not going to see growth again when it comes to sales?
Well, the way we look at our business and how our customers are shopping, it's hard to tie them directly to a channel. Our customers are increasingly shopping across multiple channels, and our strategy for some time has been to create a seamless experience no matter how they want to shop. So what we started to do last year in Los Angeles is to bring all those assets together, our digital capabilities, some supply chain capabilities we invested in there, as well as our stores and our people, to create a number of shopping journeys that were completely unique. And so those sales are showing up in lots of different places. The way we report, obviously, is one way through the segment reporting. But we look at our business as Nordstrom. And we know the customer has lots of choices on where to shop. They're not choosing between one Nordstrom store or another, or Nordstrom.com and a Nordstrom store. They want to shop how they want to shop. And so if we do a good job of creating a lot of really seamless experiences, take a lot of the friction out of it, we think we're going to get more of their business. And so far, we've seen some really encouraging signs.
And so when you connect all of those things together, the stores, the e-commerce, even some of the service locations, the local pickup mm-hmm. locations in New York and L.A., you are actually seeing a lift in sales. But why? I don't tie that together for us.
Yeah, I think New York's a good example. We opened two local service hubs, one on the Upper East Side, one in the West Village. We have our new flagship store we opened last month. And then we have what we call express services in our two racks, one on 31st Street and one in Union Square. Any customer in Manhattan can order an item from Nordstrom on their phone. They can have it delivered same day, or they could pick it up that same day or next day at any one of those locations. And for New Yorkers, you know, having a location that's on their way home from work, right by their train station, that's really convenient. It's hard to get stuff delivered to a lot of places around here. Returns is another big opportunity. We know that we're going to take a lot of returns. We're in the clothing business. And if you take friction out of the return process, we know that customers return stuff faster and we get more market share from them. So being able to really focus on a market and figuring out how do we take friction out of the shopping experience, how do we create more selection that can be delivered faster by leveraging all of our assets. And so far, particularly here in New York, it's working really well.
Yeah, returns are such a high growth part of the logistics business right now and just continuing to grow. I'm curious though, because you mentioned rack, do the discount stores help or hurt the full price stores?
Well, they absolutely help. We've got a really productive off-price business, Nordstrom Rack, NordstromRack.com, and Hotlook. We've got about 280 rack stores, and they are some of the most productive stores that we have. And the way I think about it is a customer who walks into one of our rack stores and has a great experience and walks out with a smile on their face and a bag in their hand, the value of our business just went up. And so the better job we do of giving people a great experience, no matter what format, what channel, off-price, full price, no matter how they want to shop, if we do a good job for them, the brand Nordstrom just went up in their book, and we're going to get more business from them.
Nordstrom has been a little bit more reluctant to pull holiday sales forward than some of the other retailers that we've seen. You're closed on Thanksgiving, and you hold off on decorating. But you've also set the gifts a little earlier. So why are you changing that, and is it helping drive those sales earlier?
Yeah, we've always felt that it's important to celebrate one holiday at a time, which is why we traditionally have not decorated our stores until after Thanksgiving. But we absolutely realize that customers start shopping for gifts earlier than that. So this year, much more than in years past, we started a real concerted effort to be more purposeful about having that gift assortment out by the 1st of November. We have gift hubs in much more prominent locations in our stores. Gifts are called out much more so online. And I think we've done a better job than we have in the past around really nailing those price points. We know that most gifts are under $100 and really under $50. And we've done a better job this year. We've got a ways to go on this, but having really great gifts under $50 in a great location where we can make that easier for the customer. And so far, so good on that.
The partnership with Rent the Runway, will there be more of those types of tie-ups?
Yeah, you know, we are looking to be the place where customers go to discover something new, discover a new brand, find out about a new way to buy clothes, rent the runway, and I think other models like that around re-commerce are things that customers are clearly voting for. And so we need to be opportunistic around trying things that we can. Rent the runway is just the latest, but we know that particularly the younger customer, they're going to want to shop differently. And so we can't just keep doing what we've been doing for the last 50 years. We got to find new models that are out there and bring them to our customers and see what works.
I hope you won't mind a question about LVMH Tiffany. I just wonder what people in the business are saying and what it says about brands trying to survive at the high end.
Well, we have a lot of respect for them, both of those companies, certainly. They're very, very good at what they do. And I think, you know, it's another testament to the brands matter. And particularly in our full price business, we know that customers look for brands. And it's not about price point necessarily. They're looking for brands that that mean something. And that could be Nike, it could be Tiffany, it could be Vans or Converse, Topshop.
Do you think Tiffany tried to democratize too much?
Oh boy, I'm not going to be the expert on that. I think those guys know what they're doing. I think they run a really good business. I think you know they run a global business and they're looking at their business globally, and I'm sure LVMH is as well. And they see opportunities to get some synergy out of combining those two companies, and I wouldn't bet against them.
For the holiday, you're offering free next day shipping. What does that cost you?
We've been doing free shipping for, gosh, 10 years. We know that's something customers really value. Customers don't value paying for shipping. That's easy to get your head wrapped around. More recently, we've done free next day shipping in markets like Los Angeles and New York. And the way that we can do that is because the merchandise is here. We have a lot of inventory in the market that we don't have to fly from somewhere else in the country. And so we can get it to that customer really fast without putting it on our airplane. We have just within the Manhattan market, we have probably about 90% of our total company selection that's available next day.
So we'd be remiss if we didn't ask you about the state of the consumer going into Black Friday week. What do you think?
We're really encouraged. I think we see the opportunities that we have to do a better job for our customers in giving them a great experience, serving them well, particularly around the gift-giving occasions. So far, it's very early. The customer seems to be responding, particularly in our new New York store. The reception's been fantastic. So, you know, we're not economists, but we see how our customers are shopping, and it gives us reasons to be encouraged over the next few months.